The Philippine government's debt up 2.2% in May. Data from the Treasury Bureau show the national debt was at 15.35 trillion pesos as of end May, higher by 330 billion from the end April level. BDR points to the peso's depreciation on the valuation of foreign currency denominated debt for the increase. The Philippine Trade Department releases a price guide for school supplies ahead of the opening of classes. Let's get more details with Lady Vicencio. Hi, Lady.
Yes, Denise, weeks ahead of the opening of school year 2024-2025, the Department of Trade and Industry released a price guide for school supplies. According to Trade Secretary Alfredo Pascual, the list contains information on the prices of school supplies to help consumers decide when purchasing items based on their budget. BDI's Gabay sa Pumili ng School Supplies shows price ranges for essential school supplies like notebooks that can be sold for 11 pesos and 8 centavos to 52 pesos, pad papers from 9 pesos and 5 centavos to 61 pesos, pencils are sold for 11 pesos to 33 pesos, while ball pens can cost from 3 pesos to 33 pesos. A box of crayons can also go as low as 12 pesos up to 114 pesos, depending on the number of colors. Consumers can also refer to the list for prices of other essential school items. The DTI said 80 out of 117 stock-keeping units kept its prices from last year. Around 28 items increased in price, while 9 items had a price decrease. Pascual also reminded that the price guide gives consumers a choice to go for the lowest prices in the market and to inspect labels such as the number of leaves for notebooks and papers. Denise?
Thanks, Lady. Farmers groups have filed a petition seeking a temporary restraining order before the Supreme Court against a controversial executive order of President Marcos. The farmers are questioning the constitutionality of that EO, which reduces tariffs on rice imports from 35 to 15%. They claim the EO is illegal because it was issued without any consultation or investigation. They add the EO also allegedly violated the constitutional mandate of government officials to protect farmers from unfair competition and trade practices and to develop a self-reliant national economy controlled by Filipinos. The petitioners are now asking the High Court to declare the president's order null and void.
Around 27 billion pesos set to be released by the Philippine Budget Department tomorrow, that's Friday, to settle the remaining unpaid claims of healthcare workers during the COVID pandemic. The funding will cover the payment of over 5 million remaining validated or unpaid HEA and over 4,000 COVID-19 sickness and death compensation claims of eligible healthcare workers. The agency says it's a promise fulfilled for the COVID-19 frontliners as it endeavored to release the unpaid allowances earlier than expected. Back in May, Budget Secretary Amena Pangandaman said the agency targeted to settle the arrears by the end of 2025. Several individuals found guilty of graft and malversation of public funds in connection with the Priority Development Assistance Fund, or PDAF, scam. This case involves the 2007 to 2009 PDAF of former Misamis Occidental Representative Marina Clarete, who remains at large. The Sandiganbayan 3rd Division convicted several officials of the now-defunct National Agribusiness Corporation. The sentences handed to them range from 43 years in prison up to 170 years. Former officials of the Technology Resource Center and the National Livelihood Development Corporation were also given jail time.